Today we're joined by author Marcus Blake. He's the author of Sex Game, The Lonely Girl, and Returning Home. So let's talk to Marcus.
Music is kind of a metaphor for it, so it became the music of life.
Okay.
And I can't exactly remember what I wrote at the end of the book. It has been 10 years, so you'll have to forgive me on that.
So why did you want to write about the meaning of life at 22? That's usually the age where people are just discovering themselves.
Well, again, I mean, it comes down to I knew what I wanted to do, and I knew what I didn't want to do.
Okay.
And to me, the meaning of life is being happy in all aspects of your life. You know, happy with your loved one, happy with your job, happy with your family. You know, happy with the place that you are living. And I understand as you get older, especially now, that yeah, some of those things change. But, you know, would you want to take it the Frank Capra, Jimmy Stewart, it's a meaning, you know, it's a wonderful life type attitude. You know, really at the end of the day, it's the things in your life that make you, you know, the happiest. And, you know, well, for me at that time, it was, you know, playing piano in a bar and thinking I wanted to be a professional musician and having these wonderful friends, some that I grew up with, some that I knew in college, you know, be a part of my life. So, there you have it.
Two of the most memorable characters are Chad and Charlie. Are they based on anyone?
Yes, Chad and Charlie are real characters.
Okay.
They were actually based on two of my great friends in college. I knew them down at Stephen F. Austin State University, which is my alma mater in Texas. And they were roommates who had met each other in college, and you know, to be around them, you thought that they were brothers.
Okay, they
fed nice. Off, yeah, they fed off each other. They were extremely sarcastic, scribblers in their own way. But these two very wonderful people, and I don't ever remember having a bad time with them at all. And they certainly made things more interesting. Anytime we were out in public, or we were at a bar drinking, mm-hmm. or in class, because we did have classes together. you know, when I came down and started writing this book, you know, I thought I've got to put these two guys in it because, I mean, they're the perfect archetype for the side stock characters that add to part of the meaning of your book. And so, while I took a little bit of literary license with mm-hmm. them, and I'm, you know, allowed to do that, a lot of their dialogue and how they were with each other is very much in the book is real.
Okay.
You know, how much they were around each other. So, yes, based on two real people. And I didn't change their names either. Their names really were Chad and Charlie, which I don't know why I, you know, never did that, because, you know, I've always changed the names of my characters based on people. But then again, in Sex Game, if I recall, there were a couple of characters in there that are based on real people, and I didn't change their names either. So maybe there is no rule of thumb for that in the way I write.
How did they feel about being characters in your book?
well, at the time the book was being written, I think they thought it was kind of a, you know, great honor, but all, you know, like anybody, you're always afraid. Great, how is this person going to paint me in their book? You know, or if they read it, that's not really how I am. So, and to be quite honest, after 10 years, I don't know if they've read, you know, they read the final product or not. I mean, you know, we kind of dispersed after the book got written. You know, it was 5 years later when I went into its first actual print, because it started out as an ebook and also a play. So I don't know. I think you'd have to ask them if you could find them.
We'll work on that. Well, going on to another character, I'm going to have to ask, like I'm sure other people have, who is the hurt that the book is dedicated to?
Oh, Lord. Yes, there are lots of people that ask that.
I bet.
And no, I'm not going to tell. Her name. I never
Secret.
Have. Yeah, it is. The only thing that I will say about it is based off of my first love, and